SSH is a powerful tool that allows you to securely manage remote servers, but if not configured properly, it can be vulnerable to attacks. Today I'll walk you through the essential steps to securing SSH access on your Ubuntu server and protecting your server from unauthorized access. So, before we begin, always ensure your server is up to date. This will ensure that you have the latest security patches. Let's quickly update the server. So how can we update the server? So apt is the package manager and Debian based distributions. So I can type in sudo apt update %, sudo apt upgrade, which will upgrade all the software packages that are installed. I give it the yes flag. I hit enter and it's going to work. Now that we've successfully updated and upgraded our Ubuntu server, let's make sure we back up our SSH configuration file before we make any changes. In this way, you can just restore it quickly if something goes wrong. So let me just go ahead and clear my screen. What I'm going to do now is just type in the sudo cp for copy, and then where the configuration file is stored is in etc SSH, and it's called sshd_config. Okay, and we'd like to copy that to etc SSH, sshd_config, and then just put a .bok for backup. And that has been done. We can go ahead and clear our screen now. So let's talk about disabling root login. One of the things that you should always do is to disable root login over SSH. What this prevents is attackers from trying to brute force their way into your server using the root account. So open the SSH configuration file using the following command. Sudo nano, I like to use nano, you can use any text or code editor that you like. And it's etc SSH, sshd_config. Hit enter and we can see that we opened up into our SSH configuration file. So what we can do now is that we have to find the line that says permit root login and set it to no. So we can see that a lot has been commented out. If something's been commented out, it's not going to be looked at all by the program when it's running. If it is uncommented like this, then it is going to be looked at. And for permit root login, we can just put the no flag here. We can just go ahead and put no. Permit root login, no. I hit Control O to save and then Control X and I'm out of nano. So moving forward, what we can do now after having done that is we can change the default SSH port. So by default, SSH uses port 22, which is widely known and is often targeted by attackers. A simple but effective measure is to change the SSH port to something non-standard. So to do this, we can go ahead and use the same command. I'm using nano to open my SSH configuration file. And then what I can do is where it says actually port 22, it's what it would like to use, I can change this to something else, non-standard. So I'm just going to change it to port 2200 and I'm going to save and exit. So after having initiated these changes, we're going to have to restart the service, the SSH service. So you can use systemctl or you can use service for systemctl, and service are both suitable for this. So I'm going to use systemctl. So I'm just going to go ahead and type in sudo systemctl. I'm going to restart the SSH service. I can see that it's restarted. If I do sudo systemctl and I just get the status on SSH, we can see that the status is active. So don't forget to allow the new ports in your firewall. I'll allow port 2200 and disable port 22. So you can easily use this using the uncomplicated firewall, the UFW. We went through the uncomplicated firewall in our previous video. And simply from the command line, you just type in sudo ufw allow 2200, and then you can give it a /tcp. There is an existing rule, so it skipped adding it. If it needed to add the rule, it would have added it. And we can go ahead and we can delete any TCP traffic over port 22. So we can say sudo ufw delete allow 22/tcp. Now hit enter. And I could also see that there is a non-existent rule. And this is because I've already deleted the rule. I've already disallowed TCP traffic over port 22. If you haven't, it'll go ahead and do it for you. So speaking of firewalls, let's ensure the firewall is enabled and properly configured. If UFW or uncomplicated firewall is not installed, you can just simply install it with sudo apt install UFW. You can enable UFW then with the following command. We can basically, let me just clear my screen. We can basically just give it sudo UFW enable, and it will go ahead and it tells us that firewall is active and enabled on system startup. So it's also a good idea to limit SSH access to specific IP addresses as far as you can, especially if you have a fixed IP. This way, only known or trusted IPs can connect via SSH. So we do this with UFW, the uncomplicated firewall, and I would simply type in sudo UFW allow from, and then I give my IP address, which could be 192.168.1.1 or .1.41.1 is fine. And then what I do is I go ahead and I add the ports. I set to any port number 2200 and I hit enter, and it tells me that the rule is added. Let's talk a little bit more about SSH key authentication. So to enhance security by using SSH key authentication instead of passwords is a good idea. This makes it nearly impossible for an attacker to brute force your server. So I simply type in sudo ssh-keygen t and then rsa for the algorithm. Then we give it the b flag for byte, and then I'd like it to be 4096 in size. I hit enter. It's generating a public-private key. You can save this where is actually necessary, but just for purposes of this demonstration, I'm just going to save it in home, and I'm going to create a folder, or there is a folder called SSH key pairs. I'm going to go ahead and save it in there. SSH key pairs already exists because I've already created one. If you didn't, it will create one. If I'd like to overwrite it, it will ask you for a passphrase. And our identification, our key pair has been saved. What you can do now is you can set it up in your server. And what you can actually do is you can copy this anywhere that you like. So now that SSH key authentication is set up, you can test it by trying to log into your server. If successful, you can disable password authentication altogether for better security. So to disable password authentication, we can just go ahead and we can open up our configuration file in Nano as we've done before. And we can search for password authentication, which is quite far down. There we have password authentication. We can just go ahead and uncomment it. And then what we can do is we can just add the no field to it at the end. So password authentication, no, control O to right, control X to exit, clear my screen, and now password authentication has been disabled. Once again, we need to restart the SSH service. So we just come and we use systemctl as we did before pretty easily. And we go ahead and we restart the service. So sudo systemctl restart SSH, that's been done, clear screen, and those changes have now taken effect. Finally, let's install something called fail-to-ban. Fail-to-ban is a tool that automatically bans IP addresses after multiple failed login attempts. This can help defend against brute force attacks. It's very simple. You just from the command line, you're going to go ahead and type in sudo apt, because it's Debian, install fail-to-ban. I have it already installed, so it's just going to upgrade it if it needed to. It didn't need to upgrade it, but it will install it if you don't have it. Once installed, it works out the box to protect SSH, and you can adjust its settings by editing the configuration file. And the configuration is file is found in Etsy. So let's just change directory to Etsy. Let's just Alessia, and let's just change directory into fail to ban, which is here. We can clear our screen. And inside fail to ban, we can ls, and we can see that gel.conf is there, and we can use sudo nano, and we can open up gel.conf if we want to edit the settings for fail to ban. I can just control X, exit, and clear my screen. That's it. By following these steps, you've significantly improved the security of your SSH access. Always remember to monitor your server for any unusual activity and stay up to date with the latest security patches. Thanks for watching, and if you found this helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe for more tutorials. Goodbye for now.